Hello everyone, welcome back. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the lattice and basis to get a total crystal structure. In this lecture, we will discuss about unit cells and Bravais lattice of the crystal. Let us start. As you can see in the picture, this is the lattice and the basis. When we replace the lattice points with the basis, we get a total crystal structure. Now, in order to understand the properties of the crystal, do we need to study entire lattice? No, not required. If we can study a smallest volume of this lattice, which can give the properties of entire crystal system, that should be enough. That smallest volume is called unit cell. So, a unit cell is a smallest volume of a crystal which can be repeated or translated along the three crystallographic axes so that we can get a total crystal system. You can see here, this is a three-dimensional crystal. Here, we don't need to study entire crystal to understand the properties of this crystal. In fact, if you study only this small part, this is the small part, if you repeat this small part, this is the unit cell, this smallest volume of the crystal, if we repeat in three dimensions along the x, y, z axis, then we get total crystal structure. That means, if you study the properties of this small volume, then that can be given the properties of entire crystal, That means, a unit cell is the smallest volume which can be repeating, which can give the properties of entire crystal. And also, the properties of lattice and unit cell are same. So, when we repeat this unit cell along the x, y, z axis, we get total crystal structure. So, we can call unit cell is also called as a building block of the crystal structure. So, this is about the unit cell. So, unit cell means it's the smallest volume of a crystal which can give, which will be repeated in x-axis, y-axis, z-axis so that we can get a total crystal structure. And also, if we study the properties of unit cell, that is exactly equal to the properties of the crystal structure. Let's see how many types. There are three types of unit cells are there. One is the primitive unit cell, non-primitive unit cell, and then third one is Wigner-C cell. The Wigner-C cell and primitive cell are almost the same. And we don't discuss much about Wigner-C cell in this class. We discuss about the primitive and non-primitive unit cell. The primitive cell is, if a unit cell is said to be a primitive, then it should have two conditions. The first one is, the lattice points should be at the vertices of a unit cell. If the lattice points are at the vertices of a unit cell, then we can say they are primitive cell. And also, the number of lattice points per unit cell should be 1. Let's see what is the meaning of this one. This is a two-dimensional lattice, you can see here. So this is a two-dimensional lattice where the points are arranged regularly, periodically in two dimensions. Let's connect these points, this one. Now, let us see if this unit cell is a primitive or non-primitive. As per the definition, the lattice point should be at the vertices of the unit cell. You can see here, the lattice points are only at the vertices of the unit cell. And the second point is, the number of lattice points should be 1. Here, if you see, the lattice points are the vertices of the unit cell, and each lattice point contributes 1 by 4. So, the number of lattice points per unit cell is 1. So, that means, this unit cell is a primitive unit cell. And a non-primitive unit cell means, if it is not satisfying the primitive conditions, then the unit cell is a non-primitive unit cell. Let us see here, this unit cell in the same lattice. The points are at the vertices of the unit cell, and also there is another point is lying at the center of the unit cell. That means, the points are not at the vertices of the unit cell, there is another point is lying at the center of the unit cell. So, the first condition is not satisfied in this case. And also, the number of lattice points should be 1 to be a primitive unit cell. But in this figure, we can see the number of lattice points are 1 plus 1. One is from the vertices, another one is lying in the center. So the number of lattice points per unit cell is 2. So that means this is a non-primitive unit cell. This is a non-primitive unit cell, and these are in the two-dimensional. Let us see the primitive and non-primitive unit cells in the three dimensions. Let's see, this is a simple or primitive. As you can see here, the atoms are lying only at the vertices of the unit cell, and there are 8 corners of this for this unit cell, and then 8 atoms are present at the 8 corners. So each corner contributes 1/8 part of the atom. So there are 8 atoms are there. So the number of lattice points per unit cell is 1. So a primitive unit cell means the number of the atoms should be at the vertices only. So first condition is satisfied. And the second condition is the number of lattice points per unit cell should be 1. So second condition is also satisfied. So this is a primitive. That's the reason why it was represented with P. That means it's a simple or a primitive lattice. Another one is, let's see here, this is a body center. As you can see here, in this lattice, the atoms are at the vertices of the unit cell at 8 corners. And also, there is another atom lying at the center of the unit cell. Now, if you see, 8 corners contributes, each corner contributing 1/8 part, there are 8 number of atoms are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which gives you 1. And there is another one which is lying at the center. So, total number of lattice points per unit cell is 2. So that means this body center lattice is a non-primitive unit cell. And also this is represented as I. So the body center lattice is a non-primitive. Let's see, this is a base-centered lattice. Base center means, as you can see, similar to primitive, we have 8 atoms are at the corners, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then there are 2 more extra atoms are there on the top and bottom faces of the unit cell. This is called a base center lattice. In this one, the number of lattice points per unit cell is more than 1. So this is also a non-primitive unit cell, and this is represented with a letter C. And the next one is face-centered lattice. The face-centered lattice is similar to primitive. We have 8 atoms at the corners. This is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the 8 atoms at the corner, and there are 2. This one is, this is, these two are the opposite side, opposite faces center, and these two are the center atoms of opposite faces, and this one and this one are the center of the opposite faces. That means in this face centered lattice, we have 8 atoms at the corners and 6 atoms on the center of the faces. So clearly the number of lattice points per unit cell is more than 1. Here also you can see, we can see as for the primitive lattice, the lattice point should be only at the vertices of the lattice, but there are at lattices, the lattice points are at the center of the faces. So this is also not primitive unit cell. So this will be represented with, this is represented with a letter F. So simple means we can represent with the letter P. Body center means the representative letter is I. Base center means the representative letter is C. And the face center means the representative letter F. Out of all these things, only simple one is a primitive one, and the rest is a non-primitive lattices. In summarizing the class, the unit cell is the smallest volume of the crystal. If we repeat this unit cell throughout the crystal, throughout the X, Y, Z axis, we get the total crystal structure. Also, the properties of unit cell and the lattice are similar. And we can also say the unit cell is a building block of the crystal. Thank you.